So, hello again for the millionth time. Today I'm gonna be doing a bunch of stuff that you need for your DS, which if you've got a Nintendo DS, you know you've got to buy extra junk for it. So I'll start with basically my DS itself. You'll obviously need a light or a fat. Obviously lights are better because they're smaller. But yeah, I've got Zelda stickers on mine, which I got from a Target or a Kmart. Yeah, this one's come off. You obviously know what it looks like now, you know, Zelda. It came in a pack, which also had this, but I'll cover that soon. So, firstly, for games, instead of buying games retail, you can get something like this. This is an M3DS Simply. I don't think they actually sold anymore. I'm not too sure. You can get the R4 as well, but it's basically an outdated chip nowadays. You can get something like an Ace card or an EZFlash, anything. Basically, it's a slot one device is what you want. These all take micro SD cards. I've got a 2 gig card in here, but the newer ones can take SDHC support up to 8 gigabytes currently. So I suggest if you're getting a DS to get something like this is awesome. All right, Game Boy Advance support. The DS with just the slot one card doesn't have Game Boy Advance support. So you want something like an Easy Flash 5 or V or whatever. It's got Rumble as well as memory as well. It's my favorite one. Basically, yeah, you can play your Final Fantasy VI or whatever on this instead. So that's that. Play online. If you haven't got Wi-Fi at home or if you've got WPA security, you want something like this, which is Nintendo Wi-Fi USB connector. It basically, as the name says, it's a Wi-Fi connector for your DS, so you can actually play online with this instead of having to, I don't know, go through all the other crazy methods. You'll still need internet access, but it's basically USB. Any access point will do. I just got this because I didn't have internet, very good internet back in the day. Don't really use it anymore, but you know what? One of the main parts of the DS is the touchscreen. So you get something like this. It's a 4-pack of retractable styluses. So it's basically a stylus which is retractable. So if you've got bigger hands like I do, you can actually, you know, use a bigger stylus instead of having to have something this size. A bit bigger, obviously. This thing's a lifesaver. Seriously, it can save your life. You're playing games like, I don't know, Ninja Gaiden, or any game that uses touchscreen a lot, like Pokemon Ranger. They'll ruin your touchscreen, so you want something like this, a screen protector. I actually burnt through one of these with Ninja Gaiden. I was playing the game that much. So, screen protectors are cheap and they're really good. I rush my job on screen protectors, so I don't know if you'll be able to see it. But around the borders, it's kind of, yeah, a bit worn. Not really worn, but badly done. You have to make sure the screen is perfectly clean before you actually put it on, or you'll get little air bubbles. So don't do it at the beach. If you're traveling a lot, you want something like this. It's a power brick. This plugs in through USB, which you can slide out, and charges. Then you plug in your USB cable through there to the DS, and it'll charge it for you. These things are about $10 normally, but they're good, you know, good value because they actually save you having to lose power in your save games. If you travel a lot, you can use something like this as well. Rear view stylus. It fits the extendable ones as well, only when they're retracted, or not unretracted, sorry. Slots normal DS cut slots in here, like that. And Game Boy Advance games can go up the top. Right way around. Okay, that one's not really fitting. Okay. I don't know. Anyway, it's pretty good, but I don't really use this much. If you don't really leave your computer much like me, you can use like this. It's a USB plug for the DS. Light, sorry. Yeah, not really much you can say. You get the cheapest one because they all work exactly the same. Yeah, it's really that. As for cases, I use this one, which is the Zelda one. It's padded in the inside, so I can drop my DS from a reasonable height and not actually get it to break. And it's got Zelda on it, and Zelda's just, oh, not Zelda, sorry, Link. And Link's just cool, except for in this game, where he's a bit of a faggot. And if you don't like that, you can use this instead. Very similar to sock style. DS will slot in there, and this thing here will slot in the front. aside from that, that's really all you need for your DS, unless you want to go ballistic and get extra casing and everything for it. If you do want to get extra casing, though, you unscrew the screws in it, and take out the battery that's underneath there, and you want a Trigram screwdriver, which is usually about $1 to $1.50. Aside from that, I'll see you guys next time. Hope you enjoyed this DS review thingy-majig. Ciao!